who better to weigh in than Assistant Treasury Secretary for Political Affairs, Tony Saag, who's really, I guess, the message maker here. You craft the message from the administration.
Liz, thanks for the promotion. Wow.
Yeah, I'll give you anyone. Listen, it's free. I'll give it to you.
Yeah, right.
We're so glad you're here because you're speaking to us exclusively about this, and I need an answer because we haven't gotten one from either the Treasury Secretary, members of Senate, or members of the House on this loophole. President Trump was so clear on this during the campaign. He said, that's got to go. It helped guys like me, but enough already. It really helps rich guys. It's still there, and Treasury Secretary Mnuchin was kind of, you know, tongue-tied about it when he was pressed by both Trish and Maria.
Well, what he said was not at all inconsistent or mutually exclusive. On the one hand, it is true. The House Ways and Means Committee dropped the bill. The Senate Finance Committee dropped the bill. They discussed a way to deal with it in the House bill. They don't necessarily address it as directly in the Senate bill. This is a legislative process largely, Liz. But as you point out, the president has been clear on it. And in our framework that came out back in April, we do talk about eliminating carried interest for hedge funds. But this is all going to be part of a process that we're respecting, that we've been working with the Hill, with Secretary Mnuchin, with Director Cohn from the NEC. And they know where we stand. And I think we're going to obviously try to move this issue to resolution. But that's part of their conversations right now, as you pointed out.
When you run to the Hill on a case, how many times a day are you back and forth on the Hill on any given day?
it happens often. We have a great legislative affairs team here that does it a whole lot more than I do. But look, what we've done from the beginning, Liz, and it's very important to point out, which is why we feel so well positioned on tax reform, is we came to consensus on a lot of things in the framework, a lot of the big issues. That's why you see things moving very quickly and very efficiently between the House Ways and Means Committee dropping a bill, now having it probably be on the House floor for a vote this week, the Senate Finance Committee dropping. They'll have a vote probably the week after Thanksgiving. We'll then go to conference and probably get a bill to the president soon thereafter. We're thinking by Christmas.
Okay, thinking by Christmas or not sure. I know it's not in your
hands. We feel good about it. We feel very good about it.
All right. The president today felt very good about it. He tweeted out, and he sent a very interesting message, and I couldn't tell if it's really how he feels or if it's that nudging, you know. He says, I'm proud of the House and the Senate for working so hard on cutting taxes. Then he puts in parentheses and reform. We're getting close, he writes. The market started to go up on that, Tony, but then at the bottom he wrote, cut top rate to 35%. With all the rest going to middle income cuts, question mark? That's like, you know, the CEO of a company walking in and saying, we're going to make the deadline, right? And it's going to look like what I envisioned 6 months ago that I told you guys I wanted.
Well, there's a line in there that needs to be said as well. He mentions the savings that would come from eliminating the individual mandate of Obamacare, which everybody knows was a completely egregious tax on the middle class. That's something the president's always said he'd like to see considered. However, we feel very good about where we are. Don't forget, the president's made it very clear there are two bright line tests for tax reform, that the bills need to make sure we have significant middle income tax cuts and that we make the business system competitive by lowering the corporate tax rate to 20 and the small business tax rate top rate to 25. That's achieved in both of these bills, and that's why we feel so good about it.
Tony, we've got to run. I have to ask you, is carried interest going to be used as a bargaining chip?
You have to wait and see, Liz. We've made our position clear.
You have. And that, I repeat, is President Trump saying on the campaign trail, get rid of it. It's gone. Tony, come back again. Thank you so much.
Anytime. Thanks, Liz.
See, he's not telling you guys, but he's running right now to Capitol Hill to continue that message. Tony Saag of the Treasury Department.